Right, welcome back to another Rust and Custom Productions. This is update 4 of the Hamley Page Victor build. In this update we'll be using the wings. I said I'd do a couple more things in the last update. You can just go back onto my channel, I've got a playlist highlighting all of them. So yeah, update 3 hasn't actually been uploaded yet, but it will be tonight, hopefully. Because I've had stuff to, we've been busy in that, so. And I thought I was practicing out some airbrush and did this Lego cat. I just airbrushed it like my cat. Ragdoll, not Siamese. Then I just sealed it in because acrylic paint doesn't really stick that well to Lego. Surprisingly. I don't know. First part, we'll be putting the wings onto the Victor, which is a big stage. I should grab them, they're behind the camera here. You can see they are here. There's just big slots here, and the big tabs there, and they slot into each other. The fit itself, without glue, is pretty good. Might need to do wee bits of sand in here and there, but apart from that, it's fine. You can see, not really any major gaps, so I'm gonna glue this up just now. Glue along all the edges which will be contacted with the other part. No. Just dropping my super glue everywhere. Oh, great. Woman stuck to my thing. Oh well. Right. So we'll just pierce the top of the glue with something sharp. Right, whereabouts is it? I want to find the tweezers or something. Oh yeah, I was experimenting with the micro crystal clear windows. I think I talked about it last time. I'm pretty sure I did, but I did it here just to show you. It took maybe an hour for that to set and work. Does work very well in my opinion. We'll use just pins, not box of just pins for making clothes and stuff. Pierce the top. It's usually just at the very tip of the glue sort of forms a bubble or a skin, I don't know how you'd describe it, to stop it from sticking, but here we're just gonna put quite a lot of glue. And we'll do it in this sort of recess here. Right, you just can see that, can't you? And we'll just do it along this. Should cover it. Actually, there's a small area. Push the wings out, quickly do off camera. Yep, they contact. Well, it goes on like that, so yeah, I'll just put a bit of glue here. Bit of glue here. Right, let's do it. This is a sort of one attempt thing. And it looks like we've got it. Because if you like put it on and it squint, oh my god. Right, we've spilt quite a lot of glue here. Right, I'll have to come and treat that area here. I just don't know how the glue got on there. And probably what, rewind it a wee bit and you can see where the glue came from, but I don't know. I'll probably rewind it after. But you can see that's the assemble. I can't really fit it all on camera, it's a big object. But what we're gonna do now is put it down and just grab some blue tack or white tack in my case. I'm just trying to hold these parts down, just gonna shove a bit of blue tack. Oh, I too much pressure. Just put a bit of pressure on it and see. Oh, you're not seeing this. Pressing it into place. And that'll just hold it down, you know, so it doesn't pop up or anything. There isn't a great deal of pressure on that area. Quite hard to film this. Tell you what, I'll clamp it all up and then come back when it's more or less dried. Alright, see ya. Right, hello, we're back again. I think the last thing you saw was me putting on the wings. I said I was going to put all the bracing on and stuff to hold it together while it's dried. Well, down here, in the sort of wing roots here, I just piled up with super glue. In case you didn't know this, baking powder. I've got some. Yeah, I did. Right, under my desk. Just bicarbonate of soda or baking powder will instantly cure cement, so I just piled some of that up on it and it was instantly dry. You don't have to hold it or whatever and worry about, is it fully dry, can I let go yet? It's only a few seconds it takes to dry, maybe a minute, but that's just a make sure thing. Yeah, everything fitted really well, and as you can see, I put on this sort of panel up at the top, which actually covers quite a large seam line along here, but I think it was meant to dip in at the middle. But I just got tape on there to hold it. Whoop, can you see that? Tape on there to hold it together at the moment. And now we're gonna stick the tail on that we built in part one. It's a massive kit, so it's pretty hard to film at the moment. It's gotten so big, but what I'll do is I'm gonna put some weight on this wing so it holds it. And I'll try and find something to weigh it down. Right, welcome back. I've not actually put any weight on it or anything. Just put it out, this would be the best position. I need to go do something anyway, so kind of batch down, sort of stick the tail on. By the looks of it, things are gonna go on like that. We'll grab Vel glue, make sure there's stuff coming out. I'm just gonna put a wee bit. Oh yeah, that was way too much there, spread it along. There we are, I've got a wee bead going round, and now we have one attempt at this. Really? Hang on, let me just... What the earth, how does this fit on? Alright. Let me see. Yeah, to drill a small hole in top of the tail, I'm not sure what that's for. Find out, presumably. And of course, some glue squirted out, and I'm gonna have to just let that cure. Not gonna tamper with it or anything. Next stage is the fronts of the intakes and stuff like that. Right, what parts are they? Sprue them. I've not cut anything off this sprue for ages, it feels like, because I've just been filling and stuff and putting on bigger chunks that were previously assembled. We need screw H, right. Here we have it. And what is it? You're not seeing this at all, are you? You're just seeing the Victor. I'll turn it this way so you can see the front where I'm putting them on. And for the side facing you, number 36. So we'll go and grab it. Yeah, I don't know what I'm going to do, because this kit's getting so big. It's going to be hard to fit it on. Well, it is hard to fit it on camera. Might just do a build montage after this. Might be easier, like a photo montage. We'll definitely film the painting, but I'm just not sure about the, I know, like, putting undercarriage and stuff on, and canopies and stuff. So yeah. Here we have the part, and we'll stick it on. just give it a quick test of it. That looks good. Good. Alright, grab the glue or the... What I hate when you're doing models is like you're building something and you put it down and then you don't know where it's drawn. Well, in the case of me, because I have a really messy workbench. I gotta clean up after every build. This build has been going on for over a week now. Started it last Monday, I think it was, and now it's not Monday, that not the 3 days after, but the next Wednesday, a week. It's been on it a week, and then it's a Wednesday of Monday, if that makes sense. Probably not. But I'll take off the tape securing it all together. Right, sorry, I'm doing it off camera. I'm just doing it over a bin so I can peel off and just drop it. Right, there we are. And we will cut out the other side. What do I do with the snippers? Hang on, we'll just move the Victor off camera and we'll bring it back on when I'm doing stuff on it. Here we are. Right, so we're cutting the parts off the sprue. Update 3's gone up, uploaded it. Oh, it's still going up as we speak, probably, because it's a massive file. It's like a 52 minute long video. So there's no music at the end, but because it was so big, I couldn't actually. Because normally what I do is I use Cheap Cut to edit my videos, and not trying to advertise or talk. But, yeah, and for Cheap Cut to work, you have to have the video still on your phone in your photo gallery. So if I, because that's what happened in update 2, how I lost the videos because I accidentally deleted the first couple videos. Making space, because I export it into my album and then I transfer it onto my computer and then upload it from there. But yeah, I couldn't do that, so I still had the videos, obviously, because I can't delete them, so I just took them and edited them on another editor on my computer, obviously, because it has a lot bigger storage. So, and it doesn't have any music, I don't think. I've not really used it as much. To edit, it cuts a lot faster, in my opinion. Right, next part is the very bizarre part of the transparent wingtips. So clear pressure, I'll now verify whether they're good or bad. Because the first part, I didn't open them because I didn't want them. Oh great, I just knocked the tail assembly off. Hang on. Sorry, you're just in the blank screen for about 10 minutes. Probably more than that. Right, tell you what, I'll stop and try and get this all set and stuff. When it dries, I'll come back. Alright, see ya. Right, welcome back. Sorry, I'm breaking up this video into tons of segments, which it doesn't really need to be broken up into. But anyway, here we are in another one. We're going to assemble and attach the edges of the wings. Sorry about this, it's not really wanting to cooperate. I sliced open the back for the clear parts. And yeah, so have a look at them just now. You can see that they're extremely well clear. The ones where the wings aren't, because obviously they've just been frosted out, because the only part you're actually going to see through is the wing tip. I would probably get some text here. We'll use it. Hang on, sorry, I'm not very well prepared. Just use the detail sheet and some text. Switch around to the side that it's supposed to be viewed from. As you can see, it's very clear. Sorry, my lighting isn't really giving it any justice, but yeah, we'll start with the one. We'll start with stage 72, which is the first one. So we need M2 and D1. D1 is here. I've got it. And M2 is in front of you. And M2 and M1, 2. Right. We got 1 in 4. It's a bit odd. Oh no, that's 2 there. Sorry, didn't see there's a small light here and another small light there. Right. So we'll just clip off all the bits of sprue. Annoyingly, they put the little injection pin device there. Why did you do that, Airfix? It's now just a matter of me having to clean that up. On the part that's actually going to be transparent, when you had loads of other places you could have put it. Now, I'm just going to get a rag. In this case, it's something from my airbrush cleaning set. Just to put on so it doesn't get scratched when I'm cutting up the little excess bits of plastic. Yeah, that's better. You can't really see it, it's a transparent piece of plastic. Now we will clean up the remnants here. Where's the file? Here it is, to my left. Right. So, again, we're just going to put my chair in a bit so I can don't have to stretch out so much. Now, on this clear part, I'm going to show you what I'm doing to clean it up. Right, we'll just go around all of them and do this. But this technique is one I came up with myself. You don't need to credit it by me, just say, oh, do you want to mention my channel? It'd be nice if you do use this technique. Obviously, why would you mention it if you don't use it? It's a bit bizarre. Right, we're going to take some 2000 grade Tamiya sandpaper. Right, take out a wee corner. Now we're just going to sand this edge here. You're just seeing this. Right, so it's nice and smooth, but there is still a slight bit of frosting. So I'm just going to find a bottle of it. Down here. Down in a wee box with all the little bottles. Right, so we have Meguiar's X 2.0 scratch remover for paints and stuff. Meguiar's, in case you didn't know, is like a car cosmetics sort of company. They do all the car wash, like soaps and stuff, whatever you get for your cars. So I'm just gonna rub this into the end now. Very squeaky noise it makes. Sometimes it can fog the clear parts, but you're usually not pressing hard enough. So you want actually quite a lot of pressure on this. So that's probably it. Now we're just gonna use a cloth, wipe it away, and now you can't tell there was actually a sprue attached there. Very clear. Right now, I'm gonna clean this up. I'm only gonna do one wing tip on camera because you probably don't want to see just the same thing over and over again. See what I'm doing here? Got my RCM logo. Not really a logo. My logo is my icon for YouTube. It's a wee rat rod thing that I made out of Hot Wheels. It was if you're wondering, if you're wanting to make it, I think these were the cars. What was it? The main body was a Midnight Auto, I'm pretty sure. Yellow one I used, but it doesn't really matter because I painted it a rust colour that I mixed myself, so you can't buy that shade of paint. I used for the engine an Astro Funk, I think it was called. Sorry about that. And for the motor, the grill, I used a T-Bucket. I'm not sure, or it was like a Ford Model T thing. It was like a sort of rat rod paint job on it. Well, it was like an olive drab type colour. And I used the 62 Chevy wheels, the one that came out in sort of yellowy orange a couple years ago. Or was it last year? I can't remember. Anyway, I used the wheels like that. I repainted them with white walls and just black hubs, but that was the sort of style of wheel. Can't remember what you call that style wheel. Oh my god, that's really annoying. Right, looks like we've got poly cement on the blue part. You see that? It's all clouded in the middle. Right, I'm going to let that set because it's just going to screw up a bit more if I try to tamper with it. We'll do the other side. Well, you sort of get an idea. You know how to glue parts together, presuming, if you're watching this video. So we'll let the poly cement here and I'll sand that off and do the same thing, even though it doesn't need to be done, and come back. later. Right, welcome back, guys. I probably got my hand on the speaker or something. The microphone, even. Here's the Victor. I've added a couple bits just because off camera. You can see I put on the wingtips. And the ones over there. I put on the air brakes. Which, there. Put on this wee exhaust port thingy and I put on the rear nose cone. There was a choice for either A or B, just be careful. You can see it there on the rear screen. Also, I had this Hot Wheel, I opened it up. I just noticed something, it has brand new wheels on it, if you can see. Camera's gonna focus. Nope. Anyway, they're really cool, realistic wheels. This is a really cool, realistic casting and paint job. Unfortunately, blocked this off. Used to be able to have a separate differential in there, but anyway, I don't know if any of you are interested in Hot Wheels. So yeah, next thing is putting on the things on the bottom covers for these for the bottoms of the wings. So I'll do that just now. Pop use back on stand, which uses. So put it back there. Right. A bit. I'll move this off screen and just there was a little hatch you had to paint some part 56 here. I'm not sure what it's for, it might be an air brake of some sort, but I'm gonna have it shut anyway because there's gonna be a gaping hole in my tip. Right, so for that we use, so I want to see on page 20 maybe something. Hang on, I'll go look. Sorry, I'm not showing you a bit of that. Oh, it's a wee sort of radiator. It's just another thing to paint, isn't it? I know it sounds like, oh, you don't care, just build it as simple as possible. But honestly, I don't really like masking stuff up at all. And I'm trying to find a sprue, that's why I can hear a racket. Right, that's not good. There it is, J. Still haven't painted any of the wheels up here. J13, which is here, and we'll grab the cutters. And we'll just use some scissors. Because I can't find my snips. Can't see them. Well, I can't find them. Could find them if I look. Up there they are. Seen them now. But hey ho. Right, clean this part up. The reason I didn't show you that all yet. I think the last part I messed up the clear part. I don't know. Anyway, that dried off and I sanded down the filler that I put on there. Right, this will go on like so. And there you are. That's that in. Yeah, is that good? A little overspill. Right. That's the one half of the bottom of the wing. Where's the other one? Not sure where it's gone actually. Anyway, we have one, so we can have one more bottom of the wing covered up by the panel. Right, I'll need to hunt that down, but I'll come back to you after that's dried and all that stuff. Alright, see ya. Right, welcome back. I did try to film the other wing, bottom of the wing going on, but I got interrupted, so it's not happening. Well, I could post it, it was a pretty bad video anyway. So I've attached this now, and the clips, it's really annoying for these clips when they have the rounded ends, and they just want to slip off everything it tries to, you try to clip it with. I don't know. Right, so yeah, that's this bit out of the way. I use super glue down the sort of bits that are attaching to the fuselage here and here, but I don't know if it's set yet. I'm just going to use the super glue, make a wee puddle of it. Just don't even know if you can see that. Oh, you can. Here. The one thing I hate about super glue is you put it down somewhere and then you don't forget that it's there, or it just looks like water and then you end up sticking something in it. So I'll just And the small one is super glue. Down the join. Right, there we are. Sorry, I'm not really sure to use this. But I'm just clamping it in place. And again, I think I might have shown this. Did I show you, I can't remember honestly. I probably did actually show you me putting the other side on. But I'm just going to use some baking powder. I did definitely show this. Me putting this stuff on. So, just really hard to spoon out. Because I'm using the end of a knife. And this stuff's way out of date. So, I'm not showing you this again. Right. So that done. I have applied the baking powder. Or baking soda or whatever you want to call it. Another cocktail stick and we will. No, it's more or less hardened than it. Also, it works if you put some super glue down on your work surface or something. You can just instantly freeze it up just by putting some of this stuff on it. I'm just going to use a brush here and spread it along. Right, I'll just empty the. Alright, so that, that's that done. The wing tip, just caught an arm. It's not drawing blood. Right, so that's that bit attached. There's actually a bit of a gap next to that wee flap thing, that intake that comes out. Not sure why that they're all there, but they just are, so I can't do anything about it. I mean, I wouldn't have minded if we didn't have that. Some of these parts are separate. I'm just gonna quickly go over the area with some. I think it's 240 I'm using, I'm not actually sure. Not 180, I know that. And here it is. Sand this off. Jump with a stiff brush. Yeah. After your paintbrushes are all stiff with all the paint at the top, just chop the ends off and just use them for scrubbing that stuff. Right, so we'll use some 180 because this doesn't seem to be budging this stuff. But anyway, you sort of get the idea. I'm going to come back when this is all set and yeah, so see ya. Right. Hi, we are back on the Victor build. The last thing you saw me do was put on the other bottom panel of the wing. I'm just going to grab the camera just now because it's quite hard to show this. But yeah, so I put on the bottom half of the wing and then, in a minute, I put on the jet nozzles. You didn't see that as this is an update, not a full build video. Update series, not a full build video. And they needed tons and tons of filler, and then I sanded them down and turned out they needed more filler. Don't know, I tried to sort of sand round the bits where the nozzles located in, but even that never helped, so I'm not sure what was going on there. Yeah, we'll flip it upside down. You can see here that there was quite a bit of filler needed along here. I just filled the seam here, and same for the other side. And put on just a tad more filler because there was some pitting in some areas. The gap here you can see is very small. It was like about three times the size of that on the top, so I've just left that gap there. And round here I had to fill a bit. You can see there. But anyway, so that wasn't too good a fit, especially seeing myself. I don't know why I'm saying that. So that wasn't a very good fit, unfortunately. Just put that off the side. Now, here is the blue steel missile. Now, this is not from the kit that I am building, the Victor. This is from the Airfix Vulcan, which I'm going to take you to in a minute. Unless I've already shown it. I'll show it anyway. Right, so, yeah, you can see it's really poor. There's only a few raised panel lines, and they're all really faint, and it didn't fit very well. And you see that jet nozzle there hasn't actually got a hole in it at all. It's actually quite horrible. Now we come to the one for the Victor, and that one, this one was like magnificent. It fitted together really well. There was a slight fit issue here, but that's because I slightly misaligned it when I was gluing it, so there's a step join, but that was easy to solve with a bit of sanding. Wasn't a very big step join. I'm presuming you won't get that if you do it correctly, like I didn't. And we have the part for the deploying the missile, I presume. You can see that this doesn't actually fit too badly. This is the one from the Vulcan, but the one that came with the kit, oops, that's the wrong way around, fits really well. I think I put it in the wrong way around. Ta-da. Anyway, it fits okay. Anyway, I think the next stage, oh yeah, I picked up some stuff today. I picked up some more white paint to paint it. Weirdly, Tammy doesn't do a semi-gloss white. Well, they didn't have it in the shop I went to. Tammy doesn't do a semi-gloss varnish either. So I bought some XF86, and I'll just grab a plane. Here we have, I'll tell you in a minute what this is. But you can see it's sort of slightly sheeny. And so I thought that worked well for the satin, as yeah, it's fine. Because I don't want a really flat finish, but that isn't really flat, so that was fine. I got this product. I heard lots of good things about this. Some Tamiya Extra Thin. I did show using this liquid poly, but the applicator's rubbish. I used it on this, and it worked a treat, so... Yep. I just thought I'd show you another 56 Ford. I think I showed this in this one in the last update. Yeah, I did some more rusting techniques in the bumper, because it's just a brown plastic, but anyway. That's an older cast. Well, it's an older cast, and they've sealed it up just now. I don't know if they're still making it, but we'll take you to see the Vulcan. You can see all the sprues down there, and the Vulcan, if you can see it, is there. I did, this was the one that came with the XH558 markings, which I didn't really fancy because I live in Edinburgh, so near Edinburgh is the RAF Museum. What's it called? East Fortune, yeah, and they have a Vulcan there, and I wanted to do that Vulcan, which was XN597. So what I did was, when I went there, I took a photo of the tail of it. Obviously, that's the only thing that's different, is the number and some of the paint colours, and I edited it up, so I got just the word XN597, so it's in the exact font, and I got that, and I printed it out on decal paper, which you can buy on Amazon, I think. Just use clear stuff, and so it's got that marking, and that one there is all dark grey underneath, so medium grey in the top of green. The XH558 is dark grey on the top, dark grey on the bottom, with a green camo on top and bottom. A bit bizarre that, I don't know why they'd have camo on the bottom, but still. The this Victor has white on the bottom for the other marking option. Really? Oh no, I've skipped the last page to build this. Other parts that need built, I mean, I could do the drop tanks on the top of the wings now, I think we'll do them. But, yeah, we're almost coming to the end of the build here. It's just loads of tiny wee parts, well not loads, but quite a few wee parts need to go on, like the drop tanks and other stuff. I think what we need is sprue E, do we? E and F. F is here, and E is in my hand, but it's way too big to show you. I'm just going to cut out the segment of sprue that we're needing off the right. that's the E sprue for what we need of it, and F sprue we need F6, number 6, like the prisoner. I don't know if you used to watch that. Yep, there it is. A big poster of the prisoner car up on my wall here. Right, so we'll assemble these. We'll assemble number 106. We're at stage of 106. Even though I've skipped a couple of them. Right, we need E8 and E2. So this is 8. I've lost some orange snips, so I didn't lose them. I just put them somewhere. These were handier. And E2. I'm just using these wee Goodyear ones. Pretty, they're not as good as those Xeron ones. Even though the Xeron ones are blunt, they actually cut better. Because they're made out of a tougher material than them. Yeah, I'm not too sure, but oh, there they are. They're down in the box for the victory. You probably saw that on camera and think, why does he not look there? Well, I don't know. Why didn't I look there? Right, so we've got those bits cut out, and now we will cut out. No, that's not that sprue. Right, we'll just assemble these, and we use part F6, so we've got the sprue here, and we will cut them out. I'll grab the sprue cutters, and just snip them. If you're wondering, I've seen some people polish up the sprue remnants where they sat once, but I don't feel that necessary, as it's all just going to get painted the same colour, and any slight imperfections, primer or paint will pick it up and get rid of it. So I'm not sure why people do that, but you can do it if you want. If you go in with your sanding sticks and stuff, your 2000 grade sanding sticks, I'm just like, why? It's just, it takes them 10 minutes to cut off a part. Off the sprue. What it could take 2 seconds. Not 2 seconds, maybe a minute. 30 seconds, 10 seconds. Depending on how much of the sprue you leave. What I really hate is when they have the sprue joints and then some of it lips over here onto the inside. The Tamiya Zero, the A6M3. Had that, and it was actually quite annoying because you had to go in and clean up two areas, not just the one. This one's had it in a couple places already. And it was the fuselage had it. That issue. I really just want to show you the extra thin cement in action. It says fast drying as well, which I'm presuming it is. I don't really bother about drying time on glues, because the normal poly cement is, it'll hold it even if it's not curing. As in, say if I glue these two together with normal poly cement and then added this bit on the bottom, actually it doesn't go on the bottom, but I say it did. The poly cement would hold it together so it wouldn't just fall apart when I pushed in that bit. Right. Put a new blade on this yesterday and it doesn't seem very sharp. I change my blades every month or so. So it's quite an exciting thing. Ooh, get a new blade. Oh, there's my second last blade. I know people are changing every different stage, they'll use a couple for the build stage and then change it for the paint and then decal stage really, rather. So this looks like it goes on like this. You're still videoing camera? Yes you are. That's how it goes on. It'd be easier to put the fuselage, the two halves together. Quite a nasty gap in there, so I think we'll, yeah, that's the issue. These wee bits here need more clean up. Right, that one's fine. Here. Over here. Alright, that's fit a bit better. Bit better, I'm saying. Not perfect. I'm wondering. This goes in. No, doesn't go in there. I don't know. What way does it go in? It goes up here. So that hold that in a bit better. Yeah, it does. So, right, let's see if Tammy got extra thin in action. It does smell quite a bit, I have to admit that, but so did the Humble stuff. Here you can't really see it, so I'm just gonna brush it on, but on the tutorial video that Humble put out for using the their liquid poly, it said you can use a brush, but that means you have to buy a new brush every time just to freeze it up, but yeah, I'm just trying. Yeah, you use a new brush every time, and the Humbrol brushes aren't that cheap. You would definitely have to use, oh yeah, you need to use the Humbrol brush to do this. But you wouldn't. And anyway, you need a fine pointed brush, and the ones that they, like, right, I don't know. It's a bit confusing, actually. Right, we used a blue tack to use it as a sort of connection, because I can't be bothered holding this. See, now it's the fingers, and it's putting, it's quite thick, so it's putting pressure on it. Right, so that part's together. Anyway, I showed you the doing that. I'm not sure what I'm gonna do next. Probably finish up the update after this. I'll edit it up and then see if it's worth just stopping here, or if it's too long, because the last update was way too long, I have to admit. I mean, almost an hour. And then the one before that was only like 25 minutes. So, anyway, thanks for watching. Right, welcome back, everybody. Just gonna round up the video here, as, it sort of drags on a bit. But, next update will be painting the kit. Hopefully. Maybe do some other stuff. Around the model, I've been doing various little additions. I built the instrument panel. Annoyingly, there was some injector pins on the front of that, so the decals decided to conform to them. It needs the wee handles on. I've added some like air vents. Added the sort of Bombay type bit. Actually, I had to use some plastic card in there to fill it up. Sorry, it's not really focusing. It's set on one focus when you start filming is a bit annoying. But yeah. Fit on these is actually pretty horrible. To see, I sanded these down. And I had to fill the these seams, this in between the bottom half of the wing and the intake. But yeah. I'm presuming I've not built the Revell Matchbox one, but I'm presuming this is 1,000 times better. I know the detail is, but whether the fit is, it's a bit debatable, because the fit hasn't actually been as good as I expected on this kit. Anyway, thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to not miss the next episode, because you'll want to be painting it. So yeah, bye.